Good morning, class. My name is Mr. Stevens. What do you say? Good morning, Mr. Stevens.
Good morning, Mr. Stevens.
Very good. So today, our topic will be the Boston Tea Party. Repeat after me.
The
Boston Tea Party.
Tea Party.
The Boston Tea Party.
The Boston Tea Party.
Very good. Nice job. So now we look at vocabulary. Number one, fair.
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 Very good. What is fair? This is a piece of cake. Yes, you want the cake.
I want the cake. I want the cake too.
You do, but you don't get the cake.
Aww.
This is not fair. Not this, fair.
This is not fair.
Fair.
Very
fair.
Good. Very good. Now I give you a piece of cake.
Oh, thank you.
What is this?
This is fair.
Very good. Nice job. Now you don't get the cake.
This is not fair.
Good.
This is fair.
Very good. Nice job. Very good. Number two. Occur. The Beijing Olympics occurred in 2008.
The Beijing
Olympics occurred in
2008.
Very good. The 2016 Olympics will occur in Brazil. The 2016
Brazil Olympics
will occur. Very good. Where did the Boston Tea Party occur? Where did the Boston Tea Party occur?
Boston.
The Boston Tea Party occurred in Boston.
The Boston Tea Party occurred in Boston.
Very good. Nice job. Number three, protest.
Protest.
So, I am your father, and I want you to do a lot of homework. But you do not want to do the homework, so you protest. You protest against the homework. You must do a lot of homework. What do? You protest.
I protest.
You don't want to do the homework.
No homework.
You protest.
I protest.
Very
no
good.
No homework.
Nice job. I give you a piece of cake, but you don't get a piece of cake. So what do?
Not fair.
It's not fair. That's very good. And what will you do?
I protest.
Very good. You
protest.
Very good.
Cake.
And what do you think?
You
have a piece of cake.
I think it is fair.
Very good. Nice job.
I protest. It's not fair.
Very good.
I don't want to protest.
Very good. Nice job. That's great. Number four. Board a ship. After me. Board. Board a ship.
Ship.
Board a ship.
Board a ship.
Very good. Nice job. This is a ship. This is a person. The person, he boards a ship. He boards a ship.
He boards a ship.
She boards a ship. Very good. Nice job. So what is he doing?
He boards a ship.
Very good. Nice job, guys. Next one. Number seven. Throw.
Throw.
Very good. Throw.
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 Very Very good. Oh. Nice job. That sounds great. So, I have the pen and I throw the pen.
I protest.
Very nice.
It is not fair.
Very
it is
good.
My pen.
You are right. It is not fair and it is your pen. Very good. Very nice job. So now I want you to throw the pen.
I throw the
pen. And that is your pen.
I protest.
Very good. Yes, you protest. Very nice job. Nice job. Next one, number 10, sneak onto. So repeat after me. Sneak.
Sneak.
Onto.
Onto.
Sneak onto.
Sneak onto.
What is sneak? Sneak onto. Come up here with me.
Oh, okay.
Sneak. So we are sneaking.
Sneaking.
Onto.
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 A ship.
A ship.
What do? We
sneak
onto a ship. Very good. Very good. Okay, so now we are going to do a very fun activity. Can I use you as a helper? Will you help me?
Yeah.
Okay, now come up and I'm going to give you one of the sheets with the words that we just learned on them. And here, you get one as well. And so, which is the first word? What we are going to do is read.
Board a ship.
Board a ship. Very good. So first is read. Number two is match. We have several pictures on the wall. And you need to match the word with the picture. Do you understand?
No.
Okay, so let's start over here. Board a ship. Does this look like board a ship?
No.
Okay. How about this one?
Yes.
This looks like board a ship. Very good. So you check your answer by flipping this over. Board a ship.
Board a ship.
Very good. And now we are going to make a check mark right here. Thank you. For board a ship. Now our third step is write a sentence. So now you can write a sentence about board a ship.
He boards the ship.
Very good, very good.
Do
so
I
write it down, okay. Yes. Awesome. Okay. So you can take that. So first read. Second, match. Third, write a sentence. Can you say those for me?
Sure. First, read. Second, match. Third, write a sentence.
Very good. Do you understand? Give me a thumbs up if you understand. Very good. Okay, so I am going to give you 3 minutes to go around and match the words to the pictures. Okay, get ready, go. And I want you to go over here and you can go over here.
Oh, okay.
So we're not in the same places.
Okay.
What does this look like?
I don't think it's board a ship.
I don't think it's board a ship either.
Oh.
But what could it be?
I'm confused. I think it's not board a ship.
Right, so let's look at the sheet and see the words. Which one do you think this could be?
Oh, okay, I got it. I think it's protest.
Protest. All right, let's check.
Yay,
yeah, protest. Nice. Okay.
Yeah, okay,
so now you can check off protest.
Okay, read first.
Read first.
Protest.
Protest. Very good.
Check.
Check. And then you can write a sentence.
Okay. I protest against.
Good.
My teacher.
Good. Not good. Okay.
Is it correct?
Yes.
Okay.
This
thank
is
you.
Very correct. You're very welcome. And how are you doing? Homework. That's a very good sentence. But is this protest? No? What do you think this could be? Can you find it somewhere else? Sneak onto. I think you might be right.
Yay,
very good. Okay, so we've read it, sneak onto, and then you make a check. And you matched. And now we will write a sentence.
I sneak onto the ship.
Good. Very good.
Okay.
Okay. So we have 30 seconds to finish up?
Yeah.
Are we all finished?
No.
Okay. Very good. Okay. So now we're going to play a very fun game.
Yay!
Okay. That's right. So, what I'm going to do is pass out some cards with pictures and words from the words that we just learned. So, you can pick one and pass it down. Pick one and pass it down. And I forgot, I need two. So, I will take one from here and from here. And now, we are going to take one in this hand and one in this hand, like this, and we're gonna crumple them up. And we're about to have a snowball fight.
Yay.
So, when I count to three, one, not this time, one, two, three, you're gonna go crazy and throw the snowballs at your classmates, and you can throw them at me too. And then you're gonna pick them up off the ground and throw them again. Until I yell, stop! And then we will go from there. One, two, three! Now go on the ground and pick up two. And now look at what you have. And we're going to use this sentence to see who has the pictures and the words. So let's use you for example.
Okay.
Let's see. You would say, I have
sneak onto.
And then you're going to ask the question,
do you have the picture for sneak onto?
Okay. And then I have the picture for sneak onto. So we group up, we high five, and we find our pictures. Ready?
Yeah.
Okay, we can go.
I have protest. Do you have the picture for protest?
No. I have the word for protest.
No, I don't have that. I have the word for protest. Do you have the picture for protest?
Yes, I have the picture for protest. Very good.
I have the picture for protest. Do you have protest?
Yes, I have the word for protest.
Yay!
Alrighty, we can stop here.
Thank you. It was fun.
Okay, so now we're going to play another fun game.
Yay!
All right, it is called Vocab Charades.
Vocab Charades.
Yes.
Charade.
Very good. So, you will pick a card from me, and the card will be one of the words that we studied. And then you will have to act out. Do you know what act means? You'll have to try and tell the other person. You can't speak. You can't speak at all. But you'll have to try and tell the other person through your body moving what the word is. And the other has to guess what the word is.
I get it. I'll try.
You get it? You want to try? Okay, so pick one. You can't speak, remember. No speaking.
Protest.
Yes, Very good. Wow. Nice job.
I want to kick him.
Oh, very good.
I want to do it.
You want to do it? Okay, yep. Perfect. Here. Pick one.
The same thing.
We can pick again. Come up.
Okay.
Alright.
Can you tell me? Board a ship!
Woo! Yes! Nice job! Very good. Okay.
Alright.
Okay. So now we are going to talk about grammar. Past tense. 过去时, and regular verbs. Let's first look at an example. I talk to my sister every day. Now say after me.
I talk to my sister every day.
Do you think this is present tense or past tense?
I think it's present tense.
Very good. 现在时. Now we look at past tense, 过去时. Yesterday, I talked to her. Repeat after me.
Yesterday, I talked to her.
That was very good. Now, let's look at regular and irregular verbs. So, we just looked at talk over here, and these are regular verbs because you add ed to them. They are very happy verbs, regular verbs. Irregular verbs are very mean verbs. They're angry. So, regular verbs, you take 现在时, talk, present tense, and you add ed, ud, to make it past tense. 过去时. Do you understand?
Yes.
Yes? Irregular verbs are very hard. First, you take a verb such as swim. Swim is 现在时, present tense. Swam is past tense. 过去时, you cannot add ed or ud to irregular verbs. So, let's look at a few more examples from our text.
So, I have to remember all the irregular words one by one?
Unfortunately, yes. Oh. You will have to remember them one by one.
So
that's why we have the mean face over there.
Yeah.
They're very mean verbs, but you'll get it. You'll get it.
Okay.
Don't worry. Okay. So, we already talked about the regular verbs. Now we will look at some examples from our text. The first one I'm going to read, and then you will read after me. The American colonists.
The American colonists.
One more time, please.
Colonists.
Very good. Wanted.
To protest.
The British government.
The British government.
Awesome. Nice job. Now, what is the verb in the sentence?
Wanted.
Is this past tense?
Yeah.
Very good. It is past tense. And what is want? Is it present tense or is it past tense?
Want is the present tense.
Present tense. Very good. Okay, for the next one, Leanne, I'm going to have you try and read.
The American
colonists.
Colonists loved tea.
Very good. Can you say it for me one more time?
The American colonists loved tea.
Nice.
What's colonists?
Colonists are a special group of people, and what I'm going to do is put colonists in a word bank over here. And we will come back later and it will be explained more. Okay?
Okay. Mr. Stevens?
Yes.
Can I read the first sentence again?
Absolutely, go ahead.
The American colonists wanted to protest the British government.
Awesome. That was an awesome job.
Thank you.
Very good. So, Leia, I would like to have you read the third sentence too.
Okay. Some of the colonists dressed up as Mohawk Native
good.
Americans.
Very good.
What's Mohawk means?
Mohawk, we will put it up over here too.
Okay.
And again, it is another special group of people. And we will learn more about them very soon. Another special group of people.
So are they Indian people?
They are Americans.
Oh.
Actually, they are Native Americans.
Oh, okay.
Okay. All right. So we can move on now. Okay? Our next portion is going to be on the past tense again. And irregular verbs. Remember last time, the irregular verbs are mean verbs. They're bad verbs. And remember our example, swim? Swim, is it present tense?
Yes.
Can one of you tell me the past tense?
Swam.
Very good. This is an irregular verb. Again, you cannot add ed. You have to learn them one by one. Okay, so let's look at some more examples. First, I have lunch at 12 every day. Can you repeat?
I have lunch at 12 every day.
Very good. I have lunch at 12 every day. Okay, so can someone tell me what the verb is here?
It's have.
Have. Very good. Is that present tense, Leanne?
Yes, it's present tense.
Very good. Past tense. Have, present tense, 现在时, changes to past tense, had, 过去时, because it is an irregular verb. Have, say it with me.
Have.
Present tense. Had.
Past tense.
Have.
Present tense.
Had.
Past tense.
Very good. Nice job. Okay, so let's look at a couple of examples from our text. Lei, will you read the first one for us, please?
Sure. There was tea in the event, but nobody was drinking it.
That was great. Nice job. Now, Leanne, can you tell me what the verb in the sentence is?
Was.
Was. Very good. We have was two times. And is that present tense or is it past tense?
Past tense.
Past tense. Very good. Lady, can you tell me what the present tense is? Of what?
Is.
Is. Yeah. Very good. Awesome job. Okay, so, Lei, can you read me the second sentence, please?
Yeah. They throw.
They threw.
Okay.
Very
they
good.
They threw 342 chests of tea into the water.
Very good. Nice job. Okay, so, Leanne, what's the verb in here?
Threw.
Very good. Lei, is that past tense or is that present tense?
It's past tense.
Past tense. Very good. Can you tell me what the present tense verb would be?
It's throw.
Throw. Awesome. Nice. Now, we will practice in pairs. We will practice irregular verbs. Does anyone remember what irregular verbs are?
Bad verbs.
I remember.
Exactly. They are mean verbs.
Yeah.
Okay, so we will look at these. And I will first say an example. Right here. Right now, I am a teacher. 2 months ago, I was a student. I am. Can anyone tell me what am is? Can you tell me? What am is? Present or past tense?
It's present tense. 现在时.
现在时. Very good. And Leanne, can you tell me what was is?
Past tense.
Past tense.
过去时.
过去时. Very good. Very good. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to write sentences using these structures. So you use it is, and you use something weather, like weather. It is raining. It is sunny. It was raining. It was sunny. So we're using the irregular verbs is and was. I'll pass out some paper now, and you can do this with your partner too.
Okay.
You speak to each other, and you write a sentence, and then you tell it to your partner. Do you understand?
Yes.
All set? Okay, very good. Here is that, and here is that. Okay, so we start with this one. Here. Yes?
Is this correct?
It is correct. Why don't you read it to your partner, too?
Just 1 second. It is sunny now. It was raining yesterday. What's yours?
It is raining now. It was raining yesterday.
Ha ha ha.
Sorry.
Very good.
Next one. You are very pretty now. You were
Can
not
I help you
pretty
guys
10
at
years
all?
Ago.
You're not pretty. You were not pretty. You are mean now.
You were
nice.
Right. That is a very good sentence.
Thank
example.
You.
Can I help you two?
They are.
No problems. Those are good sentences.
No.
Nice job.
They were sleeping.
And you two?
This morning.
Very good.
Now.
Excellent
they were
job.
Fighting. 2 minutes ago.
Yeah.
Okay. So now we're going to talk about the Boston Tea Party, which I mentioned earlier. Now, what do you know about the Boston Tea Party? Can you tell me what you know about the Boston Tea Party, Lei?
Yes, I know the Boston Tea Party is a very important event in American history.
Very good, very good. That is exactly what it is. Nice job. Did you know that, Leanne? No, what do you think a tea party is, the Boston Tea Party is?
They have party, they drink tea in Boston.
That's also right, but that's not the Boston Tea Party. A tea party is a party, a happy party, where they drink tea and have a fun time. But The Boston Tea Party was an exciting event, but they didn't drink tea and they weren't happy. Okay?
It's not a happy party.
Not a happy party. It is exciting though. It's
yeah.
very exciting
yeah.
and it is a very important yeah. event in American history.
Yeah.
Okay, so now we are going to look at the picture that was given to you, which is also right here. And for around 3 minutes, you are going to think of 10 words that you can use to describe the picture. Okay? Do you understand? Give me a thumbs up if you understand. Thumbs up. Okay. And you can start. Protest. That is a very, very good word, except you forgot to put the T after the E. After the O, excuse me. I can't even spell English. It's very hard. Boat. That is good. There is a boat. Can you think of another word that we used to describe a boat? A ship. Yes, that is very, very good. Nice job. Good word. And how are you guys doing?
I have ship.
Ship.
Ocean.
Ocean.
And throw boxes.
Throw boxes. Very good. Okay. How about you, Lei?
I have protest.
Protest.
Yeah, people.
People.
Yeah.
I have a question. What
sure.
do you call this? This thing.
That is a feather. And do you remember the word Mohawk Native American that we learned? Do you remember?
Mm.
No? Okay. Well, it was a word that we learned, and this is a feather.
Okay.
And what I'm going to do is put that up in our parking lot, and we can come back to it in a little bit.
Uh-huh.
You will learn more about Mohawk Native Americans and the feathers. Feather. It's what they wear on their head.
How do you like feather?
Feather. That's very good that you saw that too.
F?
Sorry, my handwriting is very bad.
Oh.
F-E-A-T-H-E-R. Can you repeat after me?
Oh, sure.
Feather.
Feather.
Feather. Very good. Do you understand?
Yes.
Is that okay? Okay. So now we have 30 seconds left to go, and we can just be finishing up. Okay. So 10 seconds left. Get your last words in there. 3, 2, 1. Let's stop. Okay. Now, what we are going to do is have you say a few of your words, and then we are going to put them into these two sentences. So, Lei, can you say your words for me, please?
Sure. I have protest.
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 Protest. And can we both say it together?
Protest.
Protest. You have another one?
Yes. Ocean.
Ocean. Let's say ocean.
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 Very good. Can you put protest in this sentence? Can you read the sentence for me, please?
Yes. I see people who...
Who?
Who are...
Do what?
Who are protesting.
Yes! Very good. That was awesome. Can we all say it together, please?
I see people who are protesting.
One more time.
I see people who
are protesting. Very good. That's great. Okay, Leanne, can you read me a couple of your words, two of your words?
Ship.
Ship.
Throw boxes.
Ship and throw boxes. Very good. Now, can you put ship into the first sentence? Can you read this for me first?
I see that there are...
Okay, now can we put ship in here somehow?
I see that there are a ship.
I see that there is a ship, is how we say it.
I see that there is a ship.
Okay, now everyone together.
But I think actually I see that there are two ships.
Two ships.
Yeah, it's in the picture.
Very good. So you can say that because R is plural. There's two things for R. That's very good. You can say, I see that there are two ships. But for now, let's just say, I see that there is a ship. Can you say it one more time for me, please?
Sure.
I see that there is a ship.
One more time, please.
I see that there is a ship.
Very good. Okay, so now what we're going to do is you're going to pair up with your partner. You two will be together and you will write one question asking something about the picture. Do you understand? Does that make sense? Okay, so now we are going to do partner work. So you will turn to your partner, your classmate, and you will think and write one question that you want to ask about the picture. Any questions? Do you understand? Yes. Are you sure? Okay, so let's start. Yeah.
We don't have paper.
Well, that would be important. Here is a piece of paper. There is another piece of paper. And you have something to write with, okay? Very good. How is your question? Why is there ship? Good. Why is there a ship? Very good. Why, say it with me one more time. Why is there a ship? Very nice. How are you doing over here? Very good. Do you have a question? Okay, just keep writing, keep thinking, and I will come back and make sure you are doing okay. And how are you guys doing? Good?
Where is it happening?
Okay, so where did it happen? Okay, so can you say it after me?
Where
did it happen? Very good. Any more questions? No? Okay. All right, so I'm going to give you 30 more seconds. Continue. Very good. 10 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Let's stop. Okay. Now, any questions? No questions? Okay, so now what we're going to do is you will turn around with your two classmates back here. And you will share your questions, and then you will go put the questions on the board. Okay? Okay?
Do we just put it on the board?
Yes, we can take, well actually.
Oh, there's some.
We have some tape. Okay. So we can take the tape and put it on the board, but first talk.
Oh, it's interesting. How did it happen? We got it wrong here.
Okay.
And you should be, where did it happen?
Okay.
We put.
Yeah. I like your question. It's very interesting.
Do you guys have any questions or all set? Okay, you can go put them on the board. You can put it up right here. Very good. Okay, everyone be seated. And looks like all the questions are on the board, so let's stop here. And move on. Next one. These questions will be, what do I want to know about the Boston Tea Party? Right here. What do I want to know about the Boston Tea Party? So, we're first going to read the question, where did it happen? Can you say after me, please?
Where did it happen?
Okay. And then the next one, Leanne, can you say it for me? Can you read this one, please?
Who drew the picture?
Very good. And Leigh, can you say this one too, please?
Sure. Who drew the picture?
All right. Now everyone together.
Who Who drew the picture?
Very good. Awesome questions. Good job, everybody. Do you have any questions about those? About the questions on the board? No? Okay. So, now, how can we learn about our questions? How can we do it? Can you give me an example of how we could learn? Yeah?
Listen to you.
Yes. That's always a good start. You can always listen to the teacher. Right. Okay.
I would like to watch some videos.
We are going to watch it. Yeah, we're going to watch a video in just a minute about the Boston Tea Party.
I'm so excited.
And can we think of one more? Read. Exactly. So we are going to listen, we're going to watch, and we're going to read. Okay. And then we will come back and say what we have learned. All right?
Okay.
Everybody understand?
Yes.
Awesome. Great. Okay, so now we're going to look at some key elements, some key questions. Number one, Leanne, can you read, please?
What happened?
Very good. Leigh, can you read number two, please?
What did it?
Who
did
it? No problem.
Who did it?
Who did it? Very good. Now, the third one, both together, please.
Why did they do it?
Okay, very good. And now the fourth together.
What were the results?
All right, very good. And these questions are going to help us later. Okay, so the Boston Tea Party again. Now the picture to the right, does this look like a tea party? Why?
Tea, food.
Food and tea. Is it happy?
Yeah.
Does it look fun?
Yeah.
Come on, right? Fun, right?
Tea and a party.
So a party. It's a tea party.
Yes.
Right, exactly. Is that a tea party?
No.
He's not really. He doesn't look like he even likes tea parties. Okay. Now, is this a tea party?
Yeah.
Why?
We just said this is an important event in American history.
Right. Exactly. Leanne?
Where's the tea?
The tea? Where do you see any tea in here? Leigh, do you see tea?
Yes.
Where's the tea?
I think the tea is in the boxes.
Leigh, very good. Very good. That's a great answer. Leanne, do you see the tea?
In the boxes.
Good. Yes. Good. Are these people having fun, Leanne?
No.
Doesn't really look like they're having fun. What might they be doing? They're all raising their arms.
Protests.
Right? They're all protesting. So, is it happy?
No.
No, it's not happy. Is it exciting?
Yes.
Is it exciting?
Yes.
Yes, it is exciting, but it isn't happy. Okay, so this is the Boston Tea Party, and this is a fun tea party. This is exciting but not happy, and this is a fun tea party. That's the difference. This was the Boston Tea Party. Okay, so can you read this for me? Both of you together, please.
There was tea in the story. But
nobody was drinking it,
and no, it was not a happy party.
Which one is this? Which one is this describing?
Yep.
Not happy, right?
Not happy.
Good.
It's an angry party.
Angry party. Right. Very good. Nice job. But there is tea. Okay. Some background. Now we're going to look at these two pictures. What do you see about these two pictures? Can you tell me something about them? What kind of clothes they're wearing, maybe?
Very old clothes.
Yeah. I wouldn't wear those clothes, would I?
No.
No.
Do you have old clothes?
I do.
Oh, really?
I have a hat.
Oh.
Just like him. Maybe I'll wear it.
Yeah.
Tomorrow.
Oh,
okay.
Thank you. I'm so excited.
But you wouldn't see people wearing these clothes now.
Yeah.
Now that you would never see people.
Many years ago.
Yeah. Many years ago. Where could this be?
America.
America, good, that's right. But a city?
Yeah, I guess it's in Boston.
Boston, very good, Leigh. That's awesome. Great job. And it was probably a pretty long time ago, right?
Yeah.
So, I think the year 1773. The year when the Boston Tea Party happened is when this happened. Can you repeat after me the date? 1773.
The date is 1773.
Very good. Nice job. And it was in where?
Boston.
Great job. Awesome. All right. So now let's look at some background review. Massachusetts and 12 other states were British colonies. What is a colony? Leanne, can you read the first sentence for me, please?
Hong Kong was a British colony.
And
it is now part of China again.
Lei, can you repeat the same sentence, please?
Yes. Hong Kong was a British colony. It is now part of China again.
Very good. Very nice. And how about Macau? Aomen.
Oh.
Can you use the same sentence structure?
Oh, sure. Aomen was a...
Portuguese.
Oh, okay. Aomen was a Portuguese colony. It is now part of China again.
Very good. Can you repeat that, Liam? About Aomen, Macau.
Macau was a British...
Was a Portuguese...
Portuguese colony. Mm-hmm. It is now part of China again.
Very good. Nice job. And here's a picture. Great Britain, China, the Hong Kong flag, and this is Britain giving Hong Kong back to China. Okay, so now let's look at the 13 colonies of the United States. These were the first colonies of the United States. Well, they were actually British colonies. Now, I'm going to point to the state, read the name, and then you can repeat. So, Maine.
Maine.
New Hampshire.
New Hampshire.
Massachusetts.
Massachusetts.
This is where we are. We're in Boston, and I grew up on this little peninsula called Cape Cod.
Oh.
Rhode Island.
Rhode Island.
Connecticut.
Connecticut.
New York.
New York.
We'll be going to New York City, which is right around here. New Jersey.
New Jersey.
Are we going to New Jersey?
Yeah.
What school? We are going to school, right?
Yeah, Columbia.
Close.
Oh.
Close.
Oh, Princeton.
Where's Columbia?
New York City.
Good. Very nice job. Mm-hmm. Pennsylvania.
Pennsylvania.
Delaware.
Delaware.
Maryland.
Maryland.
And we will be going to Washington, D.C., which is right next to Maryland. Virginia.
Virginia.
North Carolina.
North Carolina.
North Carolina.
North Carolina.
Can we say it together?
North Carolina.
Very good. South Carolina.
South Carolina.
Georgia.
Georgia.
Okay, very good. And where we are right now in Boston is part of an area called New England. Can you say New England?
New England.
New England. There are 6 states in New England. Here we can see 5 of them. Maine.
New Hampshire.
Massachusetts. Rhode Island.
And Connecticut.
And today, Vermont is part of New England. 6 states. But then, it wasn't.
But New York State doesn't...
Not part of New England.
Oh, so we are in New England.
We are in New England.
Oh, okay.
It's where I grew up.
Wow, it's good to know.
And it's one of my favorite places. Massachusetts and 12 other states were also British colonies in 1773. So where are we?
Massachusetts.
Very good. But there's all these other colonies too. So Massachusetts and 12 other colonies were all British colonies in 1773. So, can you read the sentence for me together?
Sure.
Massachusetts and 12 other states were also British colonies in 1773.
Very good. Nice job. All right, so we're going to talk about some more background information. In 1773, the British government controlled the 13 American colonies. The American colonists still thought of themselves as citizens of Great Britain. A citizen? Do you know where you're a citizen of, Lian?
You're citizens of China.
Do you know where you are a citizen of, Lian? You read the sentence, that's very good. But do you know which country you are a citizen of?
China.
China, very good. Do you know, let's say, I am a citizen of China.
I am a citizen of China.
Very good, very good. Lei?
Oh, I am also a citizen of China.
How about me?
A citizen of China.
Thank you.
Chinese.
Thank you very much. I am a citizen of America. How about Xi Jinping?
Oh,
Xi Jinping is a citizen of China!
China! Yes! Alright, good. China. Very nice. Awesome job. Okay. So, let's read our handouts. Do you all have your handouts?
Yeah.
Okay. So, you're going to read after me. The Boston Tea Party occurred on December 16th, 1773.
On December 16th, 1773.
Nice. It was a key event leading up to the American Revolution.
It was a key event leading up to the American Revolution.
All right, very good. Okay, so now we're going to do small group reading. I'm going to need you, and you, and you come up here with me. And you five will stay over there, and the other five will stay over there. And you will all read one sentence at a time, one after the other. And I will come around and help you as we go on. Okay? Are we ready? Okay, so the Boston Tea Party occurred on December 16th, 1773.
The Boston Tea Party occurred on December 16th, 1773.
Very good. It was a key event leading up to the American Revolution. Very good. Now, Lian, you start reading first, and then Lei, you go next, and then you next, and you next, okay? And if you have questions, you can ask me.
Okay.
And how are you doing over here, Mr. Snoopy? Very good, I see. Let's try and read after me. Not really. There was tea in the event, but nobody was drinking it. Now you. Very good. There was tea in the event, but nobody was drinking it. Nice job. Okay, let's everyone stop, and you can go back to your seats. And we'll start the next activity, which you will turn to the people around behind you and get into groups of four. And actually, I'm going to need two volunteers to come up and help me. Will you come up?
Okay.
Can you come up, Len?
Yeah.
And Leanne? Okay, so right now we're going to form questions, text-related questions, okay? So let's go ahead and read the first two sentences.
There was tea in the event, but nobody was drinking it.
Very good. That's great. So now, Lei, can you think of a question to ask about this sentence?
Okay. What in the event? What is in the event?
What is in the event? That's very good. We're going to take this sentence and turn it into a question. Let's try the next sentence. Lei, can you read this one, please?
The Boston Tea Party was a protest.
Okay, very good. Now, can you turn that into a question, Lian?
I don't know how.
Okay, so let's look over here. And we have a number of question words that can help us turn these sentences into questions. So we have what, where, who, which, when, how. And can you see one of these that you could use to turn that into a question?
How okay. Was the Boston Tea Party a protest?
Very good. That was awesome. Great job. Do you want, Lei, can you see how you can take another one and turn it into a question?
The American colonists loved tea.
American colonists loved tea.
Loved tea.
Very good. Can you turn that into a question now?
Sure. What did American colonists love?
Very good. Nice job. Do you know what they loved, Leanne?
Tea.
Tea. Awesome. Great job. Okay, so now we can go and sit down.
Thank you.
And does everyone understand?
Yeah.
Okay. So let's begin. Yes.
How many do we have to do?
How many? Okay, so we have 一个人读, 一个人读, mm-hmm. 然后一个人问一个问题, mm-hmm. 所以你先读, mm-hmm. 然后你问一个问题,
我要读几个问题。你可以读一个,
mm-hmm. 一个。
Do we need to write the sentences?
Yes, you actually do need to write the sentences.
Oh, okay.
So
okay.
Let's give you a piece of paper.
Okay.
And then you can write your sentences down.
Okay.
Okay. Any more questions? Okay. Questions. How can you form a sentence? If you have trouble, you can look up over there on the board, which is a little hard to see right here, but you can move over here and look up on the board. And we have where, who, which, when, how. And we can turn this sentence into another one. We can turn the sentence into a question. Very good. Very nice. Any more questions?
No.
No? Okay. Very good. Any questions? Nope, you're right. That is a very good mm-hmm. question. What did the American colonists protest? You said it exactly right. Very nice job.
What did the text call?
Okay, so we're going to end in 30 seconds. Okay.
The British government also told the colonists to revive in the British company.
Okay, 10 seconds. And 3, 2, 1. Let's stop. Okay? All set? Okay, very good. Now we'll collect your questions. Thank you. And now we're going to watch a movie. Fun, right? All right.
I like to watch movies.
I know, me too. Okay, so what have we learned? So we talked a little bit about the Boston Tea Party. Can one of you tell me when the Boston Tea Party occurred?
December 16, 1773.
Wow, that was amazing. Very good. Your history is very, very awesome. Now, where did it occur?
In Boston.
In Boston. Very good. But where in Boston?
Oh, at the harbor.
Yep, very good. At the harbor. And what did they do in the harbor?
They throw the tea into the ocean.
Into the ocean. Was it a fun tea? Was a tea party. Was it a fun tea party?
No, it's an angry tea party.
An angry tea party because they were all doing what?
Throwing tea? Oh, protesting!
Protesting! Yes, very good. Okay, and why? Leanne, can you answer?
They were angry.
At who?
At the British government. They were angry at the British government.
Yes, they were. Do you remember why they were angry at the British government?
Because the British wants to tax them.
They wanted to tax them, exactly.
Yeah. So they protested against the British government.
Right, exactly. Very good. That's awesome. You guys remembered a lot. So now we can think of three more things that you learned, and you'll turn to your partner, and you have pieces of paper here. And I want you to use these words to think about three more things you learned about the Boston Tea Party. And I will give you a few minutes to do that, okay?
Okay. Three more things. What did you learn? Mm. Oh, the 13 colonies.
Very good.
Can I just write 13 colonies?
13 colonies? You actually should make a full sentence. What about the 13 colonies? Who?
Massachusetts.
Okay.
Our 13 colonies.
Massachusetts is one of. The 13 colonies.
The 13 colonies. Oh,
very good.
Massachusetts.
That's good though. You choose one word that you know and then you try and make a sentence out of it. Very nice.
Thank
That's
you.
A good job. Does anyone need help over here? No. Looks good. Okay.
They pretended. Mohawk. Yeah, Mohawk. They wear Mohawk.
How do you spell Mohawk?
Mohawk. They pretend to be
Very
Mohawk.
Good.
Yeah.
All right. So we have 30 seconds. Ten seconds. Three, two, one. Let's stop. Rhett, finish your last sentence. All set? Now you can bring them to me. And I'll take them. And I'll give these back. Grade them. And we will now go out and explore the city. That's the end of class. Good job.